Stevie finally had her baby. She had the baby just before midnight last night, and she did really well, but she wasn't letting the baby nurse initially. She's quite bruised, and so we have some cream for her. But last night, every 20 to 45 minutes, we had to try and help them nurse, and it was a long night. And it was freezing last night, like absolutely freezing. It snowed. It's May 1st today, so. But it's nice again today. Both mom and baby did really well. However, we did run into a few issues in the night. Stevie kept pawing all around the baby, and so kept moving all the straw away from the baby, and so it just couldn't get a footing when it was trying to stand. It was exhausted, and we decided to step in and help out. Ideally, you want to let the baby do this on their own for muscle coordination, but at this point, the baby needed to get up so that it could try and nurse. We had been trying to give mom and baby some time to bond, and so an hour at this point in, and we still didn't know if we had a colt or a filly. The anticipation was killing us.
Daddy, is there a little boy? Little boy?
Oh, 2 year old.
Yeah. Boy.
No, look, I think that she did hurt its leg. Because that joint is swollen.
Where?
At the front. That's the one that was sticking out first when she got up and then went down.
No, I don't think so.
Well, mommy, but the vet's coming tomorrow, so you can just ask her to tell us. The doctor's coming tomorrow.
Yeah, but look how weird it is. Its joints aren't weird on the three legs.
No.
I mean, baby joints are always weird.
Not on the baby. Like, hey, baby's not. Oh, that baby.
Figures out how to glue it.
It's a smart one.
You like being coming in?
How long until he needs to drink?
2 hours from birth.
The next problem we ran into was Stevie did not want to let this baby nurse. We were trying to get them to kind of figure it out on their own for nursing, but that didn't go well. Stevie kept circling, so every time baby would go towards her back end, she would turn so that she was facing the baby. With all of the preparing we did, all of the research and the reading and asking the vet, I forgot to pack a baby bottle. And so I don't have baby bottles lying around anymore. And it was like 2 a.m. at this point. Nothing's open. And I needed a baby bottle to help nurse this baby. We had a calf bottle, not a baby bottle. So learn from our mistake and make sure you have a plastic syringe or a baby bottle on hand in case you run into the same problem in the middle of the night. But essentially, we were in touch with the vet, and she had said basically, like, you need to do whatever you need to do to get this horse to allow the baby to nurse. So we tried putting a halter on Stevie, and that didn't help. We tried holding them kind of in place, and that didn't work. We tried bribing Stevie with food to keep her still and to take her mind off of a baby trying to nurse, but that didn't work. Because it was getting critical and we needed the baby to get that colostrum, we had to restrain Stevie into the corner while one of us held the baby and then had to put some milk onto our fingers, have the baby suck that, and then get that sucking reflex working, and then slowly direct the baby's head into where it needed to be.
Just coming in to check on the new little addition. She's passed out.
So last night, Stevie would not let the baby rest at all. She was just constantly pawing at her because she wanted her standing. And as soon as she was laying down, she was right back to kicking at her and pawing at her. So she has a lot of rest to catch up on. It was a rough night for her too. So we were helping out every 20 to 40 minutes with feedings throughout the night. And after the first couple of hours, we were slowly able to work up to releasing some of the restraints for Stevie. And gradually we were able to get her to feed with us just holding onto her halter in the middle of the stall. And this morning at around 7 in the morning, she started feeding all on her own and is settling into her new role as a mom. If you want to see more videos of this adorable little baby, make sure you hit subscribe, like, and the notification bell. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Barn Boots and Country Roots.